Welcome to the segmented configuration booting the PS first tech module. Here is the agenda for this tech module. We will focus on the need for faster boot processes, introducing the segmented configuration flow for enabling accelerated boot time, describing how segmented configuration works, describing how reconfiguring the programmable logic works in the segmented configuration flow. As technology advances, the pace of development and deployment has become a critical area of focus. Modern computing systems require faster software boot processes and updates to meet the growing demands of today's world. Users usually want the runtime software, like Linux or another OS, up and running out of DDR memory as soon as possible. One effective method for accelerating boot time is by deferring programmable logic configuration to a later stage. This approach enables the system to configure the PL only when necessary, optimizing both performance and efficiency. By keeping the PL domain inactive until required, power is conserved and overall system effectiveness is improved. The other use case is when the dynamic loading of the PL happens remotely. Here, the system can swiftly boot up to U-boot or Linux by using local boot flash, which minimizes storage needs while enhancing flexibility. Subsequently, the PL image can be dynamically reloaded from a centralized image repository or directly from the boot device. This ensures that the system always operates with the most current configurations, adapting seamlessly to the ever-changing needs of modern technology. Here are the current software stacks for the AMD Zynq UltraScale Plus MP SoC and the Versal Adaptive SoC. The image on the left shows the software stack for the Zynq UltraScale Plus MP SoC. Once the boot ROM loads the FSBL, it begins executing and retrieves the necessary executable file or files from non-volatile memory. The FSBL can then optionally load programmable logic with a full or partial bit stream. When completed, the control is passed to either the user application in the case of a standalone system or to the second stage bootloader, such as U-boot, which then takes over. In the standard flat flow for Zynq MPSoC devices, the PSDDR configuration is carried out during the boot sequence, specifically as part of the PS init process. This is because the DDR is part of the PS. As a result, the PL can be reconfigured without impacting the PSDDR or software running on the DDR. Hence, the PL configuration part is optional in this flow. However, the situation is different in Versal devices. Here, the RCU, after all mandatory security checks, loads the PLM, which takes control of the boot process. The PLM then reads the PDI from the boot source and configures the components of the system, including the NOC initialization, DDR memory initialization, programmable logic, and processing system, and then completes the device boot. In this flow, the NOC, DDR, and PL configurations are closely interconnected. If the PL configuration is executed at a later stage, it can affect the DDR configuration and consequently the system software running on the DDR. The time consumption by NOC, DDR, and PL configurations can make the boot process slower. To bring the Versal flow more in line with the MPSoC process, AMD has introduced a new approach known as segmented configuration starting from the 2024.2 release. The segmented configuration flow from AMD is a new, revamped approach from the ground up designed to align our solutions with the features and boundaries of our silicon rather than being dependent on existing tools. This has been achieved through a collaborative effort among the AMD Versal Adaptive SoC, Vivado software, and embedded groups, with an emphasis on ease of use. The term segmented configuration comes from the fact that the entire booting process has been split into two distinct phases. This approach is not only scalable, but also offers a generic path for users to achieve faster boot times. The fundamental goals of this new flow include booting processors, memory, and OS before loading the PL, allowing flexibility in PL configuration, that is, deferring the PL configuration to a later stage, building a Vivado tool solution based on a standard flat design flow which simplifies the overall process, minimizing restrictions, complexity, and the need for user intervention, thereby offering a user-friendly experience, ensuring compatibility with related solutions such as PED Linux, PCIe Tandem, DFX, fallback, and security features, delivering a PL PDI via Linux or U-boot at runtime. In essence, this segmented configuration flow makes the booting process more efficient and user-friendly for customers using AMD solutions. This flow is in production in Vivado 2025.1 and is enabled by default for AMD Versal Prime Series Gen 2 and Versal AI Edge Series Gen 2 devices. This slide compares the software stack of the AMD Zynq UltraScale Plus MPSoC with that of the Versal device with the new segmented configuration flow. If we compare the flows on the right side and focus on the PL part, the segmented configuration flow allows users to configure the NOC and DDR initially during the boot sequence. There is then a choice to load the PL at a later stage based on user requirements. This is why the PL is marked in a dotted line at the top of the stack, showing the flexibility of the flow to load the PL based on user needs. In order to achieve this, the PDI image needs to be slightly different between these two flows. This shows the PDI images that are used for the Versal device legacy flat flow and the segmented configuration flow. Compared with the legacy flat flow, in the segmented configuration flow, the important point is that there are now two PDIs that are generated. First is the PS boot PDI, and the second is the PL PDI. We'll learn more about these different PDIs in the next few slides. The segmented configuration flow splits the entire booting process into two distinct phases, as shown here. The initial PS boot PDI is generated in such a way that everything except the PL design is configured in phase 1. This PDI contains the entire PS, PMC, DDR, CPM, and related GTs, and the horizontal NOC information, which is mainly responsible for configuring the PS, DDR, and other essential components. The PL PDI is then delivered in Phase 2, in which the entire PL is configured, including the user design, the vertical NOC, transceivers and I/O, and other hardened blocks in the PL. This PL image is fetched from the boot device or from a remote storage location. This flow provides the ability to retrieve PDI images dynamically over runtime software like U-boot and Linux. Now that we've looked at the segmented configuration phases, let's see how to enable this flow in the Vivado IDE. In the Vivado Design Suite, the name Segmented Configuration can be seen throughout the Vivado flow only when the enabling parameter is set. To set this parameter, start by opening a Vivado project session. Once the project has been opened, set the project property that initiates the segmented configuration process. This is done by selecting Tools, Settings, General, and then selecting the Project is a Segmented Configuration Project option. The property can be applied using Tickle as well. Once segmented configuration is enabled in the AMD Vivado Design Suite, this leads to a Zynq MPSoC-like deployment of the PL, automatically allowing the booting of the PS before the PL. In this flow, when the PL image is created, the standard design flow is still utilized for creating and implementing AMD Versal designs. However, the tools require an additional piece of information before PDI generation, the identification of the necessary network-on-chip connectivity for the initial boot image. It is essential to declare all NOC paths that must be present before the PL configuration. This is done within the AXI NOC IP under the Quality of Service tab. The QoS tab contains an initial boot column, where all paths entirely within the PS domain, FPD, LPD, etc., and those accessing DDR or HBM memory are selected by default. If any path from this list should be excluded, the corresponding checkbox must be deselected. Paths within or connecting to the PL domain cannot be checked, as they are not feasible options for the initial boot image. This information is then passed through the implementation tools, going through DRCs, and stored in a database for PDI generation decisions. After the necessary tool options are selected in the AMD Vivado IDE, the next step is to create the PDI images. For the segmented configuration flow, the hardware tool creates two PDI images. The first PDI that is generated is the PS boot PDI. This PDI contains PLM and PSM executables and other necessary images required for PS and PMC configuration. It also contains information on the NOC power domain and DDR configuration. Minimal NOC configuration is performed. That is, only the essential NOC required for static initial path is configured. This is the first PDI, which is loaded as part of the initial boot sequence. The second PDI is the PL PDI, which contains the rest of the programmable logic. It is the dedicated PDI for the PL, containing the user design and full NOC configuration. Along with these PDIs, there are some hardware specifications that are captured in the XSA file for the downstream tools. On top of the PS boot PDI, users have different options to add different images to these hardware tool-generated PDIs and extend to the full boot PDI as shown on the right. This ensures that the necessary system software is up and running. The full boot PDI can be created using different software build flows, including BootGen or the Vitis Boot Image Generation Wizard. Device tree management is also taken care of at this step. Note that considerations for secure boot remain the same as those in the flat flow. After these decisions are made, the PDI image is generated and programmed under system software control using conventional boot devices such as QSPI or obtained from remote storage via PCIe or Ethernet interfaces. This approach allows users to quickly boot to an operating system while access is enabled to as much DDR or HBM memory as necessary and to load the PL PDI at later stages based on different options and requirements using runtime software. Another point to consider here is that the segmented configuration and secondary boot flows both benefit from each other, providing a faster boot of Linux or RTOS with smaller images on the primary boot and relatively bigger images on the secondary boot device. The segmented configuration approach enables users to delay delivery of the PL PDI image. Moreover, users can dynamically reload the configuration of the PL on the fly, changing the functionality of the design in the PL domain. This effectively provides a simplified entry point to a dynamic function exchange-like solution without requiring the use of a full DFX design flow within the AMD Vivado design suite. However, it is important to establish consistency between multiple runs so that the NOC usage and interfaces match. To ensure consistency between implementation runs and their corresponding PDI images, the NOC solution is locked and then can be exported from one run and imported into another. This is done with a pair of tickle commands, write NOC solution and read NOC solution. Each of these commands has a single option, File, to reference the JSON-formatted NCR file that is exported and imported, respectively. The recommended approach to establish consistency from one project to the next is to create a golden project and spawn all new variations from this source. This can be done by saving a copy of the golden project using Save Project As or by sourcing the same project tickle script that created the golden project. This ensures the same PS domain consistency from the top-level block design name to NOC IP configuration and NOC connectivity. If designers expect to modify the NOC usage within the PL domain, either entirely in the PL domain or the PL NMUs connecting to the PS and SUs, it is advisable to separate this dynamic portion of the NOC into one or more unique NOC IP instances. This allows the PS NOC to more easily remain untouched from one run or project to the next. Once a design is complete and is routed, first lock all the NOC path segments that are tagged with the initial boot property, as well as all the segments connecting the PS domain to the PL. Then export the NOC solution from a routed design checkpoint and write it as an NCR file using the write NOC solution command. To replicate the NOC solution, read in the NCR file by setting the NOC solution file option within the implementation run properties. This option calls the read NOC solution tickle command prior to running place design to apply the NOC solution from the initial run. Once the second design image is completely implemented, run the PR verify command, which will confirm that the NOC solutions are identical and the PL images can be interchanged. This must be done directly in the tickle console to identify the two routed checkpoints to compare. In addition to checks within the Vivado flow, a runtime check is done whenever the PL image is loaded or reloaded onto the target device. Here, the PLM performs design version compatibility checks during image load. Unique identifiers are inserted in the PDI to ensure compatibility of the boot image with any incoming PL image. To accomplish this, the Vivado IDE calculates 32-bit hash values for each partition and inserts these in the PDI. Segmented configuration offers full PL reconfiguration without requiring a DFX flow in the AMD Vivado IDE. The slide illustrates the PL reconfiguration sequence for this flow. When PL reconfiguration is being performed, the first important point is that the user has to make sure that there is no activity happening between the PS and the PL during the image reload. That any activity on the NOC related to the PL design must be paused, and any remaining transactions from the NMU must be flushed. This is a user responsibility. The second step is to unload or load drivers as needed before or after PL reconfiguration. This means applying the device tree overlay by removing the outgoing DTBO and adding the incoming DTBO with respect to the drivers. In the next step, once everything is done, request the PLM to reconfigure the PL PDI using the image stored in the image store or boot device. In the final step, users can resume their activity and access the PL as normal. This slide shows how PL reconfiguration happens using the PL PDI. Here, the assumption is that the software is up and running and the user has the PL PDI, which can be fetched by the software application that is running on the hardware. The software loads the PL PDI using any high-speed interface, such as PCIe, Ethernet, USB, or another boot device, and then requests PLM services like libDFX to create and store a DDR image into DDR memory. This allows the PLM to reconfigure the PL PDI whenever the software application requests it at runtime. This also prevents the runtime software and PLM from accessing the boot device at the same time.